want you to start with inhaling to look up at the sky, chin all the way up. And then very slowly bring your chest, chin all the way to your chest as you exhale. You can do that two more times. And one more time. Okay. Now come to the center and I want you to go sideways. So bring your ear to one shoulder and then the ear to the opposite shoulder. So neck bending side to side. Do it about two times on each side. Do it in such a way that they can repeat it if you want repetitions. And let's twist. Now look to the right after you're done on both sides. Look to the right. Come back to the center. Very slowly look to the left. Come back to the center. Do that one more time. And one last time to the left side. Beautiful. Come to the center and let's start neck rotations. You can do maybe two clockwise and two counterclockwise. Beautiful. And once you come back to the center, place your hands next to your hips. You're going to stand about one foot away. Interlock your fingers. Okay, let's start. So hands by the side first. Okay, now interlock your fingers. And now from here, turn your palms towards the floor and lift your hands all the way up. While you raise the arms, bring it in one line with your shoulders. You don't look up, you keep looking forward. And now raise the heels off the floor. Yeah, you can stay there. Keep stretching. Make sure your hands are close to your ears. For 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. Now slowly bring your hands down first and then slowly bring your heels down. Would you like to do that one more time? Okay. Slowly look forward, interlock your fingers, turn it around and then take your hands up. When you're ready, lift your heels off the floor. Pick that point eye level so you're a little more steadier. Keep staying for about 10 counts. And then when you're ready, you will come down with your hands and then your heels down. Okay, now we go into the tree pose. So the Vrikshasana, you're going to continue standing where you are. You're just going to lift that one leg and bring the right heel to your left opposite in the inside of your left thigh. Hands by the side, you can shoot yourself just taking your hands up. So take your hands slowly all the way up in a namaste. Stay there, and when you want to come down, you can't hold it any longer. Bring your hands down first and then bring your leg. And slowly repeat on the opposite side. And from here, slowly bring your hands down first and then your leg down. Stay there for a few seconds. Stay steady. Look forward. Okay. Now what we can do is we can get into the Surya Namaskar. So this is quite like good enough to just warm up. Pranamasana, yes. Now raise your hands as you inhale. Take your hands up to the ceiling, to the sky. You can arch your back. As you exhale, go all the way forward and try to flatten out your palms next to your feet, forehead towards your knees and stay there. Stay there for 2 to 3 seconds. Okay. Now we're going to go into Anjani Asana. So you're going to take your right leg all the way back into a lunge. Look forward, arch your back, don't drop your knees, stay there for a few seconds. Beautiful, palms flat on the ground, don't move it. Now left leg back into a plank. Look forward at the forward edge of the mat. Yes. Ashtanga Namaskar, where you're going to drop your knees, chest, chin, elbows close to the body. Beautiful. Come up all the way into Bhujangasana. Roll your shoulders back. Extend your toes. Shoulders down, open up. Smiling collarbones. Beautiful. Stay there for a few seconds. That correction was good. And now raise your hips into a downward dog. Adho Mukha Svanasana. Push your heels into the ground. Use that flexibility you have. Push your chest all the way back. Beautiful. Look at your belly button if you can. Okay. Now we'll get our right leg all the way forward back into Anjani Asana into a lunge. Right leg forward in one line with your palms. Palms flat. Don't move that. Beautiful. Stay there for a few seconds. And now let's get the left leg forward all the way. And again, palms flat, forehead towards your knees. You're going to take your hands up all the way. Exhale, flatten out your palms, forehead towards your knees. Left leg back, inhale into a lunge. Right leg back into a plank. No breath as you drop your knees, chest, chin. Inhale up to Bhujangasana, extend your toes. Exhale into a downward dog. Raise your hips to tiny steps in, push into your heels. Step your left leg forward, Anjani Asana, inhaling. Step your right leg forward, flatten out your palms, forehead towards your knees. Inhale, your hands go all the way up. And remember, when you exhale, you just come back into Namaste by your chest. Stay there for straighten out. Yes, now turn, look forward at the camera. Bring both your feet parallel. We'll directly go into the opposite side. Left foot to the left side, right foot in 45 degrees. Turn your torso, bend your knee and take your hands up. Hands up, hands up. Lovely. Stay there again. 5 breaths. Make sure that left... I can't tell if the left knee... Is the left knee crossing left ankle or what? Can you tell? Because then the pose will be wrong. Huh? Okay. Just stay there for a few more seconds. And when you feel like coming back, you can. And then we'll go into the warrior 2. And okay, now stay here, keep breathing. Let's begin again. Now again, now turn your right foot to the right side, left foot in 45 degree. Keep looking at the camera, keep looking at the camera. Okay, now open up your hands in shoulder level. Okay, now look to the right side and bend your knee. Yes. Now make sure, what you can actually do is look at your right hand, turn your head, look at your left hand. So the cue can be that your hands should be in one straight line. You can look back and forward. Make sure that they are in one straight line. Now look forward. You have to be fierce like a warrior. Squeeze your shoulders together. So stay for a few more seconds. When you feel like coming out, you can. Slowly come back. Yes. Bring your hands down. Turn again. Parallel feet. Open up your hands and then bend the left knee. Beautiful. Stay for a few seconds. When you're ready, you can come back. Okay. Now stay there again. Bring your hands in a namaste. Take a few seconds. Okay. Now we are going to do the Trikonasana. So for the Trikonasana, again, turn your right foot to the right side. Bring your left foot in 45 degree. Look at the camera. Don't turn your torso. Open up your hands shoulder width. Okay, now lean to your right side. Lean to your right side and then go down. Try to flatten out your palm on the ground. Beautiful. And look up. Beautiful. Keep pulling your left hip bone back. Keep staying. The left arm is in like one straight line with the right arm. Yeah? Okay, stay there for like a few seconds. When you're ready to come up, remember to keep everything straight. Your hands, your upper body will come back first. Your knee is still straight. Okay, I think it's time to come up. Inhale. Okay, relax your hands and bring the leg back. Now let's do it on the opposite side. Open left foot 90 degree. Keep looking at the camera. Keep looking at the camera. Right foot in 45 degree. Then open up your hands shoulder level. Now lean to the left. Lean towards your plants. And then go down. Very slowly go down and look up to the right side. Beautiful. Your palms should be facing the camera. And then slowly come up as you inhale. Bring your hands down first, look at the camera. And join your feet and then make a namaste. Just stay there for a few seconds, that's it. Now we'll come to seated. Keep your back straight, okay. So this is also called Dandasana. So we can just say that like for 5 breaths, stay in Dandasana. You want to sit with your spine erect, you know, the sit bones into the floor. And when you're ready, let's go into butterfly, your Baddha Konasana or your Bhadrasana, whatever you call it. Make a namaste with your feet. And slowly pull and clasp your toes together and back straight as much as you can. If your thighs don't touch the floor, it's fine. If you're not as flexible, your heels can be slightly away from your groin. That's also okay. I think we can add a little bit of flapping here just to show the beginners how to, yeah. Okay. And slowly release, stretch your legs forward. Okay, now from here we'll just get into a Pashtamottasana because we're already in this pose. So take both your hands all the way up as you inhale. And as you exhale, hinge from your hips and try to go around your toes. And breath. We can do one like that and one sideways or whatever you choose.
Okay, I'll just do one like this for
yeah,
now.
Okay. Yeah, and slowly go forward. Grab, yeah. I think it's nice to show the clasping of the fingers because you're nice and flexible. Keep pushing your forehead towards your knee. Slowly come up, inhaling, and then slowly come down. Nice. Stay there for a few seconds and then you... And exhale, forward fold. Try to interlock your fingers, stay there. Okay. Try to bend your elbows a little more if you can. Yes. And just stay there for 5 breaths. Okay. Now slowly come up. Take your hands all the way up. And release. Okay, now we're going to continue from here into a Vajrasana, okay? So that's a nice continuation. So you're going to take one leg back, then the opposite leg back. And we'll go directly into a Vajrasana. Okay. Yeah. From here, just make a little pocket. So heels away and that pocket. And this is really important. And your palms should be downward on your, close to your knees, huh? Yeah. Okay, stay there for a few seconds. So this is your Vajrasana. Okay. Okay. So again, so you're kneeling. Now support your lower back with both your palms. Okay, roll your shoulders back and just arch your back as much as you can. Try to look at your plants and just stay there for a few seconds. And then slowly come up. Stay there for a few seconds again. We'll do it again. So we'll bend the back and then you take your hands and grab the heels. When you're ready. And now grab your heels. Beautiful. And just stay there. You can drop your head. Keep pushing your pubic bone forward. So it'll be a lovely arch. Now, when you come back, we are going to go into a child's pose very slowly, okay? So now slowly come back one at a time. Now sit back in Vajrasana. Now open up your knees in Vajrasana and go into a child's pose. So open up your knees in a V. Yes, push your stomach down and relax. Yes. And extend, keep stretching, keep straightening out the spine as much as you can. Okay, beautiful. Slowly come up and now you're going to lie down on your back. So now I think we'll do, say, Setu Bandhasan, but we'll also do Chakrasan, even though it's not a beginner pose, it just looks beautiful. Okay? So bend both your knees. Keep the hands by the side. Okay. Inhale to imprint your spine. Exhale to lift your hips up all the way to the sky. Keep pushing your pubic bone up as high as you can. Stay there for a few seconds. You can interlock your fingers underneath. Squeeze the shoulder blades together. Lift. Maybe stay there for 3, 2, 1. And bring the hands by the side. And then slowly come down one vertebrae at a time. Slow. Slow, 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 slow. Okay, stay there. What we can do is we can just push up to a Chakrasana and you can just add that if you want to go a little deeper or you're stronger, you know, if you like. Your choice. Okay, so let's get into Chakrasana. Take your hands back. Stay there for a few seconds. Maybe if you want to come a little lower, so in your center of the mat, but or it's fine if it's a continuation. Keep your legs active. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Keep your legs active at all times, and when you're ready, push up, all the way up. Beautiful. Stay there and push your chest back to your plants. 5, 4, 3, 2. Now chin to your chest, so you slowly come down and you make that very smooth. Chin to your chest, now bend your elbows and come down. Slow, 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 slow. Beautiful. Now immediately bend your knees, hug your knees, Pavan Muktasana. And because you've inverted, get your forehead towards your knees. Yes, stay there. Again, just stay there for some time. Okay. Slowly release. Release your legs. Take your legs up 90 degrees and let's go all the way up to Sarvangasana. Okay, now you can drop your toes at the back. Remember to keep your knees straight. Okay, one by one. Okay, now your hips have come back too much. Take it over your shoulders. Walk back with your toes a little bit towards the plants. Towards the plants, no, the other way. Just stay there for 2 or 3 more breaths and then support your back and go back into shoulder stand. Slow, slow, slow. Okay. Now again, I want you to come down one vertebrae at a time very slowly. Very slowly, that transition should be very slowly. Okay. Right. Now again, we can, since we've already done the child's pose, you can just show that child's pose in between here if you want, or get into it again because this was an inversion. Your choice. And let's go flat on the stomach. Open up your knees. Open up your knees. Yeah. Okay, beautiful. One more thing you can add. Come onto your fours and just do a few cat cows. You don't have to use this for this video, but keep your knees. So make sure your hips are stacked over your knees, shoulders over wrists. Now turn your toes in. Inhale to look up. Arch your back. Look up. Push your your belly button towards the floor. Nice. Your elbow should be straight. Now when you're exhaling, chin to your chest, round your back and extend your toes. Do that a few more times. Tuck your toes in again. And exhale again. Just one last time. And exhale. Beautiful. And now you can go flat on your stomach.
Ma'am, please pause for a while.
Okay.
Yeah, thank you.
Slowly go down. Now we'll go into a full Bhujangasana. So you take your hands a little lower and then push into a full bhujang. Remember to roll your shoulders back and smiling collarbones. When you're ready, come up, inhaling, smiling collarbones, open up, beautiful. Stay there. Keep pushing your pelvis down. Just a few more seconds. And then you can slowly come down. Okay, maybe you want to come, do that coming down again. It wasn't very smooth. So go up all the way, and when you're coming down, bend into your elbows close to your body and slowly come down. Yeah. Okay. Now hands by the side of your body again, hands near your hips. Okay, now we'll get into Dhanurasana. So forehead on the ground. Okay, fold both your legs in. Grab your ankles. The soles of your feet should be pointing to the clouds. And come up into Dhanurasana. Come up all the way, yeah. Now keep pushing your toes back towards your plants. Keep opening up your chest for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. And slowly come down, release, and then turn your head to one side again. Hands by the side of your body, turn your head to one side. You can also do that sleeping pose if you want. That's more government style. Okay, stay here. Now we'll go into Shalabhasana. So Shalabhasana, you can either make fists or make palms underneath your hip bones, where only your legs come up.
They're changing the carb. Just show me what I need to do this, so I'll do
okay. This one. So your hands are here and then only your legs come up. Wait, you can't see my legs, no? But you know what I mean? Like to get it till the thighs. Wait. This one.
Ha 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 ha.
But the forehead is down, huh?
You had a crazy day, haven't you?
After you're done with 30, just stay with your breathing. Okay, now the same thing, how your hands are, you're just going to put it on, the right hand will come inside, sorry, your left hand will come inside, closer to your groin, and the right hand will do anulom vilom. And let's begin. Close your right nostril, inhale from your left. And exhale from your right. Keep putting the thumb on the third eye. Yes, now inhale from the right. Close both nostrils, put the ring finger on the third eye and exhale from your left. Okay, we'll do one more round. Okay, start. Inhaling from your left. Now close both and place your thumb on your third eye and exhale from your right. Now again, inhale from your right. And now exhale from your left. Okay, now we'll show one more variation, okay? So now we'll inhale from your right. Sorry, inhale from your left, my bad. Now close both nostrils and show some retention. Stay there for a few seconds. And then when you're ready to exhale, exhale from your right. Then again, inhale right. And close both nostrils, stay there for a few seconds, retain the breath, and then show exhaling from the left. And we'll do one last round, which is 1:2. So inhale from your left for about 3 seconds. Close both and exhale from right for 6 seconds. Now inhale from your right again for 3 seconds. And double your exhalation from your left nostril for 6 seconds. Okay, now again I just want you to stay in dhyan. Slowly bring your hands, touch the tip of your thumb to the tip of your index finger again. Okay, and just stay. So we'll just call this like meditation, dhyan, whatever you want to call it. Just stay with your breathing. Make sure all those three fingers are extended, the remaining three. Your spine is erect. And if you like, you can do some om chanting here maybe, and you're done. Because we've already done the shavasana part. So now we'll start with the Vishnu Mudra. So Vishnu Mudra is your thumb and the last two fingers, right? And let's begin. Close your right nostril. Inhale from your left. And exhale from your right. Keep putting the thumb on the third eye. Yes, now inhale from the right. Close both nostrils, put the ring finger on the third eye and exhale from your left. Okay, we'll do one more round. Okay, start. Inhaling from your left. Now close both and place your thumb on your third eye and exhale from your right. Now again, inhale from your right. And now exhale from your left. Okay, now we'll show one more variation, okay? So now we'll inhale from your right. Sorry, inhale from your left. My bad. Now close both nostrils and show some retention. Stay there for a few seconds. And then when you're ready to exhale, exhale from your right. Then again, inhale right. And close both nostrils, stay there for a few seconds, retain the breath, and then show exhaling from the left. And we'll do one last round, which is 1:2. So inhale from your left for about 3 seconds. Close both and exhale from right for 6 seconds. Now inhale from your right again for 3 seconds. And double your exhalation from your left nostril for 6 seconds. Okay, now again I just want you to stay in dhyan. Slowly bring your hands, touch the tip of your thumb to the tip of your index finger again. Okay, and just stay. So we'll just call this like meditation, dhyan, whatever you want to call it. Just stay with your breathing. Make sure all those three fingers are extended, the remaining three. Your spine is erect. And if you like, you can do some om chanting here maybe, and you're done. Okay, from here, back straight. Okay, look forward. Slowly bend your left knee. Raise your right hand up to the ceiling. Go around your left knee and look to the left side. Look at the back and twist. You can grab your ankle. Yes, and stay. Stay for a few seconds. So you can just show ankle and knee because you're more flexible, whatever you want. And then when you're coming back, first bring your hand back. Look forward, straighten out your leg. Switch your side. Bend the right knee, raise the left hand up. Then twist and then look at the back. And then slowly bring your hand back first. Look forward, straighten out your legs. Yeah. Back straight and you're done.
Please do subscribe to Shatama Rambavati.